Today I'm going to be giving you some tips on wearing your mermaid tail in the tub. Don't know why you say goodbye, I say shalom. So I'm going to be giving you some tips on things you can do as a mermaid in the bathtub and how to get mermaid practice and also some tips on taking mermaid pictures in the tub. Alright, my first tip is go to the bathroom before you put your tail on and get in the tub. Because if you forget to do that, if you say, it's okay, I barely have to go, and then you get your tail on and then you make your way to the tub and you're sitting in the tub, you're not going to want to take your tail off, get out, and pee. So just do it beforehand. Yeah, I think taking a bath should be like a healing thing, you know? So you want to get the most out of it. Maybe throw some essential oils in there, make it smell super nice, some rose petals. It's okay to get all dressed up for this. Sometimes we need to get dressed up as a mermaid. Like, you just need it. First of all, I have to fill the tub with water, so do that. Siren arm dance is body set your phone up in a stupid way. Don't let your phone fall and get wet. Phone is okay, I think. Anyway, back to the video. I have a really big tub, as you can see. If you have a really big tub, then don't. This tail's not too bad, but I would just wear a fin fun tail if it weren't for the size of this tub, or just any small finned tail. Oh god, I almost set my hand on fire. This is not easy. Not easy, nor is it comfortable. So, another tip I have would be to use your bath for a photo op. You can get some cute pictures, or in my case, videos, in your mermaid tail in the bathtub. Just take pictures of your selfies, pictures if you are like me and you set your phone up with like a tripod thing, then set that up and I'll take videos and do some poses and screenshot at the moments where my pose looks good. So I've taken some pictures and as I said, I set up my camera and forget the whole video thing. I do a timer on my camera, so I'll set it up, it'll give me 3 seconds and then I'll pose. And that's how you can take your own pictures and videos, basically. You know, because I don't... Dang it. Stupid thing. And I'm going to show you a TikTok that I made where I give you another cool tip for taking a mermaid bath. Pro mermaid tip. For some really nice photos, just add food coloring to your bathtub and some flower petals. I put a little bit of green, a little bit of blue in to make it have a nice kind of oceany look to it. I also thought it would be nice to put some rose essential oil into it. I was feeling a little extravagant. So some more tips that I have for taking a bathtub. Another tip for taking a bath in your mermaid tail is, as I mentioned, there are some ways you can practice your professional mermaid skills in the bathtub, and one of those ways is to
I've got my tub high enough that I can go under. And basically what I would do is I would just go underwater, or at least submerge my face. And then you can kind of practice making facial expression, pretend that the bathtub is actually a mermaid tank, and that there's an audience watching you, and just practice making faces underwater, and, you know, pretend that there's guests and interact with them. Use your imagination, as SpongeBob would say. Oh, and don't almost set your tail on fire. I'm gonna move that a little bit far away from the flame.
Try sitting like this. It's kind of comfortable.
My arms are sore from holding the camera, and my feet are sore from not being able to extend my fin all the way. I'm comfy. I'm really surprised I haven't straight up dropped my phone in the tub yet. Oh, I don't know if I did it just then. And this has been Tail Time in the Tub. Bye bye, everyone. Toodaloo. I just felt like saying toodaloo.